Hello everyone, this video is for you if you have a mid-size or smaller companies that have 500 employees or less. So we're going to be explaining you what you have to do through this time of coronavirus and what the benefit relief the government provide for your company.
The U.S. government, so this is for U.S. companies.
So as I already mentioned, in this response or family first coronavirus benefit, you have to have 500 employees or less.
Yeah, it's like a refund kind of reimbursement, but it will be only when you file your 2020 taxes. So it will be like a tax credit after this year.
Yeah, so don't expect receiving a bunch of money from the government right now. So you need to make sure that your company can survive through this time, and only then you'll be able to apply for this tax credit.
So how this work? We will give you the link to the government so you can read all the details, but in general terms, it's all about the workers that have been affected by the coronavirus. This case can be two main cases, that they are sick, your workers are sick, they got into the quarantine, or because of
the lockdown
of the city, of the states, is not allowing your workers to actually do the work. Or the other main reason is that your workers need to take care of their family members that have been sick, or are taking care of the kids that are not going to school or daycare. So this is like the main two reasons that your worker cannot do their job as usual, or because they need to take care of the family.
Yeah, and the government requires you as an employer to notify your employees. So there is, I'll just read it, a notice of FFCR requirement that, again, we're going to provide a link for the website, that you have to print it out and you have to put in your building notice, send it by email. Just make sure that all your employees are going to be notified. So again, you need to make sure that you count all your full-time employees, your part-time employees, and make sure that all of them know about that.
Yeah, and you are expected to follow all the regulation, this act, because you need to take care of your workers, and you are responsible to give this paid leave. And if you are not responding as an employer, as a responsible employer, and give this paid leave to the employees that are qualified, that meet all the requirements, you will be
penalized by the government.
So make sure you go through all the act and make sure you understand it, like, to the details, because you need to be a responsible employer. We know that we are all in this crisis together, and you are being affected as well, your business. But now, as they say, it's family first response. So we are taking care of the family first.
So what we just talked about, this is the federal government help. So you definitely have to look into your specific state and what benefits, what relief help they provide, and follow those guidelines. As well, if you're a company of 50 employees or less, you're gonna have some exemptions.
Yeah, you had to prove, if you have 50 employees or less, that if you give this paid leave to your employees, your business might be affected, might go bankrupt, might lose their businesses, like all of this, that it will affect your company in a way that you cannot continue giving them jobs. So that's kind of the idea of the
exemption.
So if you have less than 50 employees and your business, let's say, is a cleaning business, and your business cannot run without your employees, half of them, or you see that your business will not survive this period with your employees on paid leave, you have to provide the information to the government and you can get
exemption from providing this benefit to your employees.
Yeah. And if you have more than 500 employees, you are a big company, you are not into this act. So this act doesn't apply to this kind of businesses.
That would be all for this video. Again, we're going to be attaching some links for you below the video, so you can go, you can check what you need to print, what you need to be showing your employees, and what you have to be doing through these difficult times. I hope you're safe. I hope you stay healthy. I hope you continue running your business without closing, because this is the biggest fear of a lot of entrepreneurs with companies right now, that most of them, unfortunately, will not be able to survive. So we're going to cross our fingers for you, and hopefully you get out of it in one piece and continue with your business. Have a good day and stay healthy.
Bye-bye.